Hello, Accounting 101 students. In this video, we will go over how to perform tabular analysis using the data presented in our Chapter 3, End of Chapter Practice Exercise, Question Number 4. So for Question Number 4, we are given 9 business transactions. And for our tabular analysis, we need to include the effect of each transaction on the accounting equation. So we need to determine if the transaction would impact assets, liabilities, equity, revenue, expenses, or dividends. To make this a bit easier for us to read, I have copied all of these 9 transactions over to the side so that way we can talk through and discuss each of these. So as you go through these problems, you'll need to categorize each of these into the appropriate account. And if it increases any of these aspects, you're going to put a positive sign or no sign at all, actually. In Wiley, it's better not to put in a sign. If there's going to be a decrease, that's where you want to put in a negative sign or a parentheses. So in our first transaction, the company issued shares of common stock. So common stock is going to be my equity account that's going to be impacted here. And it was issued to investors in exchange for cash. So the company received cash, so there will be an increase in cash. And there will be a corresponding increase in common stock. And you'll notice that both of these are going to be on opposite sides of our basic accounting equation, which is assets equals liabilities plus equity. So we're going to have an increase in cash, which will increase our assets, and a corresponding increase in common stock, which is an equity account. So we'll have a corresponding increase, and these two amounts will equal out. So in your Wiley problem, for cash, you're going to see an increase of $173,000, and you should use the number that's in your problem. And you will also see an increase in common stock. So you'll put in $173,000. You'll notice that $173,000 on the asset side equals $173,000 on the common stock sign. And the explanation is that the company issued stock. In our second transaction, the company borrowed $50,000. So anytime you borrow money, that means that you have money that you're now going to use and you're going to pay it back later. So we borrowed cash, so there will be an increase in cash. And we borrowed this money by issuing bonds. So bonds payable is a very large borrowing. And we're going to go ahead and increase our cash account by $50,000. And we're going to have a corresponding increase in our liabilities, which is the amount that we owe, of $50,000. So you're going to see $50,000 on each side of that accounting equation. And for this particular item, you don't need to include an explanation because there's no impact to stockholders' equity. In your instruction, it says to put an explanation only if it increases stockholders' equity. So you can leave that field blank. All right. So the third example that we're going to go through is the company purchased delivery trucks. So we're going to have an increase in our asset. Specifically, our delivery truck is going to be referred to as an equipment, and we're going to have a decrease in cash because we needed to pay for that delivery truck. So in this example, You can see that the two accounts that we're going to be using both impact the assets side of the accounting equation. So we have a negative $53,000 for cash because we have a decrease in cash. And we have a corresponding increase in equipment. So we used up our cash in order to increase our equipment. So one thing you want to notice is that you do not need to impact both sides of the accounting equation. The accounting equation just needs to impact at least two accounts, and it has to balance out. And so your equation balances out in this case. Next, we have the company received $14,000 from customers. So this amount is coming from customers. So we received cash from our customers for services performed. So we're going to have an increase in our cash account by $14,000. And we're going to record an increase in revenues of $14,000 because we have earned that revenue. And you will notice that you need to include in an explanation the reason for this change in the stockholders' equity account is revenues. And even though revenue is not directly reported on the balance sheet, it is indirectly affecting the stockholders' equity section of the balance sheet. The way you can think of this is realizing that revenues increase net income, which increases retained earnings, which then increases the stockholders' equity section on the balance sheet. So it's more of an indirect impact for revenues. All right, our next transaction, number five, the company purchased supplies. So supplies are a resource that a company has. So my supplies are going to be in the current asset section for $3,700 on account. So we purchased supplies, but we didn't pay for it yet. So in this example, we need to include an increase in supplies. And we need to include an increase in our accounts payable liability. So you'll notice I don't have any impact to cash. I'm going to increase my supplies by $3,700. And I'm going to have a corresponding increase in accounts payable. Next, we have transaction number six, in which the company paid rent of $5,400. So anytime you see the word paid, that means there's going to be a decrease in cash. So one of the quick notes I want to make for you guys is the word paid will lead to a decrease in the cash account. So we're going to record a decrease in cash. So in your cash column, you're going to see negative $5,400. And you're also going to see rent expense. And you'll see in this particular problem, they've grouped all of the expenses together. So in the expenses section, and you'll remember that expenses reduce the net income. So that reduces retained earnings and it reduces the equity. So you'll see that this particular expense amount is going to reduce your equity. So that's why we have this negative sign. And the reason why there's a change is for rent expense. On transaction number 7, the company performs services. Anytime you see perform services, that means that the company is earning revenue. And it is on account, so that means that the company has not been paid yet from the customer. So we'll have accounts receivable. On the asset side, you're going to see an increase in accounts receivable of $10,800. You're going to see a corresponding increase in revenues of $10,800. And the reason for that increase is service revenue. For transaction number 8, the company has paid salaries. So you see the word paid, that means there is a decrease in cash. And the reason for that decrease is the salaries that were paid. So the company needs to record salaries and wages expense. So we're going to have a decrease in cash. So we'll have the negative sign in front of the cash because we're paying money out. And we are paying that money to our for salaries and wages expense. So we'll have a negative sign here and we'll include the increase. The last transaction that we have is paid a dividend. So we're going to decrease our cash. And we also are going to record the dividend in the dividends account, which is going to reduce retained earnings and reduce equity. So you'll have that negative sign. And the reason is for the dividends that were paid. And for your cash account, you'll include that negative sign. The very last part of doing the transaction analysis is that for each column, you're going to add and subtract all of the respective amounts. So obviously the cash account will take you the longest to add and subtract all of the amounts from all of the transactions. Something like accounts receivable, supplies, equipment is a little bit more straightforward in this particular problem. And what you want to do is make sure that everything that is on the asset side of the equation, so if you were to add up all these assets, this will equal your total of all of your liabilities, so your accounts payable and bonds payable, and your common stock, and the three factors that affect retained earnings, which are revenues, expenses, and dividends. So your accounting equation should balance out at the very, very end of this problem. So thank you for taking the time to watch this video.